The Palestinians are pushing ahead with their plan to gain full membership at the United Nations, even though the United States has already promised to veto it.
Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas is meeting with international leaders today to gain support for his move before he submits his formal request on Friday. Heather Sells has that story.
President Abbas is pressing ahead with his diplomatic campaign to win full membership in the UN. He's meeting with French President Nicolas Sarkozy and others to line up support ahead of his speech. A spokesman says Abbas is telling everyone 20 years of negotiations are enough. The world should intervene. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is calling on Abbas to meet him in New York, saying he wants to resume peace talks. A spokesman for Netanyahu says the Palestinians made a commitment 18 years ago to solve all issues of contention through negotiations.
They are in clear violation of both the spirit and the letter of signed agreements. This is a violation of Palestinian commitments. This cannot help peace.
Representatives of the U.S., European Union, and Russia are meeting to try to avert a divisive showdown on Friday. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton is joining Netanyahu in calling for new talks, saying the only path to Palestinian statehood is through negotiations with Israel.
We continue to believe and are pressing the point that the only way to a two-state solution, which is what we support and want to see happen, is through negotiations.
Reports say Israeli security forces are preparing for the possibility of an outbreak of Palestinian violence in Israel. Secretary Clinton, meanwhile, says there's still time to find a solution to this diplomatic crisis. Heather Sells, CBN News.
I don't have much hope that we're going to find a diplomatic solution to the crisis. The Palestinians could have had an independent state long ago. In Oslo, Arafat was given he could have had one. The only requirement was that he had to recognize the state of Israel. And he knew if he did that, he would likely be assassinated. That's what's driving this. More than anything else, the reason after 20 years of peace talks there is no peace is it would require the Palestinians to recognize that Israel has a right to exist. They refuse to do that. So if the UN acts on this, and it's likely they'll go to the full General Assembly, all 197 nations, and say, or 193 nations, and say, will you vote for us? And if that's ever established, all will be established will be yet another terrorist nation in the Middle East. Lee Webb has the rest of our top stories from the CBN newsroom. Lee?
Well, Gordon, before the looming clash over Palestinian statehood, President Obama plans to focus on Libya. He opens 2 days of meetings at the UN today. The president is first meeting with the chairman of Libya's National Transitional Council. Then he and other heads of state will discuss the international community's success in ousting Muammar Gaddafi. Libya still faces numerous problems, including the strength of radical Islamists within Libya and the role they may play in a new government. The U.S. military's Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy has ended. It ended officially today, and some military chaplains say the new acceptance of open homosexuality could mean the end of their religious freedom. Congress voted last December to lift the ban on homosexuals serving openly. Ron Cruz is the executive director of the Chaplain Alliance for Religious Liberty, and he wonders what will happen if a chaplain, say, prevents an openly gay soldier who volunteers to teach Sunday school or turns away a gay couple at a military marriage retreat.
We're doing away with one Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy, but we're going to have another Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy, and it is, if I hold biblical values concerning homosexualities, don't ask me about them. Because if you ask me about them, I'm going to have to tell you.
Cruz says one chaplain expressed a biblical view on homosexuality, and a general officer told him to either get in line or resign his commission. Italy's credit rating has been downgraded by the same agency that lowered the U.S. rating. Standard & Poor's lowered Italy from A+ to A Monday with a negative outlook for the future. S&P cited Italy's weak economy and unstable government for the move. Italy has a larger government debt than any European nation except for Greece. Its economy has shown no significant growth in more than a decade. Italy is the world's seventh largest economy, and a default could threaten other European economies as well as the U.S. Gordon?
Well, this is one of those where they're getting criticized for the downgrade, but in actuality, the downgrade should have happened long ago. Italy's bonds pay at 6% interest rate, and that's unsustainable in the current environment, and there's no real market for it. What is the spinoff effect? Well, it's likely to be another banking crisis. This one focused in on the banks of Europe who have bought Italy bonds and Italian bonds. If those ever get into a default, there'll be a follow-on effect that'll affect the banking system, not just in Europe, but around the world.